What is life? How would you define that little word, life? It's interesting to me to read what some people have said about it. For instance, John Christian said, life is the art of drawing without an eraser. Robert Frost, a rather famous poet here in America, described life saying, life is tons of discipline. And sure enough, we do have to learn to discipline ourselves throughout life. Nikita Khrushchev, back in 1958, was quoted in the New York Times as saying, life is short, live it up. But perhaps the one that came closest to gathering what the Bible really says about life was Shakespeare. In the play Macbeth, it's just after his received word that Lady Macbeth is dead and they're storming the castle where he's at. Macbeth says, life's but a walking shadow, a poor player that struts and frets his hour upon the stage and then is heard no more. It is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. That expression, he says, that life is a tale, is that which comes closest to what the Bible says about it in the book of Psalms. There the psalmist says in Psalms chapter 90, verses 4 through 9, says, for 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as a sleep. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withereth. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath, and here it is. He says, we spend our years as a tale that is told. I've talked about this before because it's always been an intriguing thing to me, that the psalmist says that our life is like a tale that is told. And you stop to think about that. Another year goes by in our life, and that year is just like another chapter in the tale that is told. And as we think about that and our life being in that way, as the 1 year ends, it also reminds us about the faithfulness of God. And being reminded of the faithfulness of God ought to be an encouragement to us as we look at our life, as we pass another year, another chapter of our life being told. We need to recognize the fact that we're getting closer to the last chapter in that tale. And because of that, we need to make sure that the life we're living right now, the tale that's being told in our life, is a life of obedience to God, of one who is a faithful child of God. You know, when John Christian said that life is the art of drawing without an eraser, that sounded good to me at first, but then I began to realize, no, not really. Because you see, our life is like a tale that's told, and we do have an eraser. There's a possibility for us to edit our life, that we can rewrite the things that have been done. We can go back and we can cancel out all those mistakes we've made and have all of those sins removed. But when a person becomes a child of God in obedience to His will, believing in Christ, repenting of his sins, confessing Jesus before men, he's buried with Christ in baptism, at which time all of his past sins are washed away. What a blessing that we have an opportunity in this life of ours, this tale that's told, that we have an opportunity to correct all the mistakes we've been made. And even for one who's become a child of God, if as God's child we're not really living for Him the way we should, and we continue to make mistakes, we continue to sin, but we know we have an opportunity every time we can repent of those sins and pray to God and know that He will forgive us. And again, we can make those corrections and the mistakes we made. We can edit out that tale that is told, and hopefully then come to the end of our life having lived the best chapter of our life that we've ever lived. And we can come to God then in peace and be blessed by God with that home with Him eternally in heaven. Tonight, as you think about your life as a tale that's told and you consider the chapter that you're living right now, if that chapter or chapters before are things that are not suitable to God, then we would encourage you to take the opportunity you have to make the corrections, the additions that done to that, by responding to God in obedience to His will. We would encourage you, if you need to do so, please come to God now while we stand and sing.